We've seen newspapers from the New York Times and the Wall Street Journal, and now yesterday, Chuck, the Washington Post. I want to read you just something from the Washington Post editorial board. Mr. Obama and his administration have seized on a report from a website run by the Liberal Center for American Progress to argue that the U.S. Chamber of Commerce is using secret foreign money to influence our elections. It goes on to say, the foreign money is kept actually in segregated accounts. The White House seems willing, says the Washington Post, to stoke xenophobia without any evidence for its accusations. What do you make of that?
Well, look, it seems as if the White House has lost this fight on the facts, but they're not dropping it. And let's, you know, there was a, when you played the Karl Rove excerpt, he's sitting there and goes, hey, they're trying to, you know, change the subject here a little bit. That was the implication. Well, yes, you know, that is what they're trying to do. And they're also trying to speak to the Democratic base at this point. They're not trying to persuade. There's no more persuading going with the electorate. This is now a battle of turnout. And Democrats at this point, their only shot at saving their majorities is somehow ginning up the Democratic base. They believe this issue helps them. If they can figure out how to put a face on this issue, the campaign finance issue, not a persuadable issue, the middle of the electorate, you know, nobody likes money in politics. Everybody will tell you that. That's one of those easy things for people to say. And you know, nobody likes negative ads either. But that doesn't mean the electorate punishes candidates who do it. And so at this point, it's more of a base conversation that the White House is having. And that's what this is about. Look, they've been grasping for some sort of message, an attack on Republicans at work. In August, it was Bush, right? They used the Bush name. Well, it didn't work. In September, they tried the car analogy, you know, the ditch, back and forth, DNR. And now they're trying to do this. And they're not backing off because they like that they've drawn Rove and others into a rhetorical fight because they think simply having the fight with Rove will fire up the Democratic base because they don't fear firing up the Republican base because they don't need any more firing up.